We have a lot of earthworms in our yard because we rarely use any chemicals. But last year, we were invaded by the hammerhead worms, and they have really reduced our earthworm population. How do we get rid of hammerhead worms in our yard besides pouring salt on them when I find them? And this is Terry. So there have been a lot of reports, you know, about hammerhead worms.
It's definitely an invasive species.
Invasive species, of course, it does eat, you know, our native earthworms here. Also, it feeds on snails and slugs.
Which is good, but then again, I really would rather have my earthworms.
Yes, I would rather have the earthworms. So according to some publications that I've seen recently from Missouri Extension, is one, Alabama Cooperative Extension, another, is this. There's not enough known about the hammerheads yet as far as control goes. So they're actually recommending using salt, using vinegar or citric acid.
I was thinking citrus.
So you just have to be careful, you know, about using too much of that, because that will change the dynamics of your soil fertility.
Sure will.
Right. So those right now are the recommendations until we learn a little bit more, you know, about the hammerhead worms.
Yeah, destructive.
That's going to be destructive, isn't it?
Yeah.
And something else I read in those publications, don't cut the worms in half.
No, because then they're like the earthworms. Then there'll be two of them.
Yeah, it'll be two of them. Oh. Yeah, so don't do that. But you usually see them after a heavy rain. They, of course, come up to the surface, and they are devouring our earthworms. How about that?
Well, you know, if you weren't queasy enough, after a rain you saw them, to help keep the salt and everything out of the earth, you could just kind of collect them all and then... But who wants to go out there and collect all of them?
Yeah, you have to still get rid of
it. You know.
And then, too, you might want to wear gloves
as
you're doing this. Because, again, we don't know enough about the hammerhead worms. So, maybe some toxic, substances, present within those worms. So, you have to be careful, with that. But, golly. And, of course, hammerhead because, the head is shaped like a hammer. But, it's like, golly. How about that? As much as we love our earthworms, and there's something out there attacking the earthworms.
Yeah, we need, and the birds need the earthworms, and even the moles need the earthworms.
Yeah. And so a lot of the reports that I've read said that these hammerhead earthworms made their way here, plant material.
Oh, dear.
In pots.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're so small that you can't see them. So by the time you plant them in the ground, there they go. They start to multiply. So how about that?
Well, hopefully they'll be better research done, and we'll get a better solution.
Hopefully so. Yeah, the surrounding states are already seeing them, so it's probably somewhere here present in Tennessee. Thanks for watching. If you liked it, subscribe. We have hundreds of family plot videos for you to view.